And this question comes from superfan Peter Sage. Peter writes, "Oh my God, first. This is where knowing your fabricator's registration capabilities becomes paramount. Design within them and Bob's your auntie. For those of us who go to the rapid prototyping fabricators, this has to include choosing component footprints that won't challenge their capabilities. Another consideration is if you need to route traces under the solder mask slivers between pins." Not really a question, more of a comment from Peter, but he does bring up a couple of really good points about solder mask expansion, which I think a lot of folks don't think about, and that is the size of the leftover solder mask sliver. If you take a look here on screen, you will see that we have three footprints, all for the same component, from my podcast episode with Elizabeth Bustamante, and you can see what the solder mask sliver is just by looking between adjacent pads. You can see that within these footprints, you'll have some leftover solder mask between the pads due to the solder mask expansion around each of these copper pads in these footprints. Now, how big does that solder mask sliver actually need to be? And do you need to have a different value when you're working with two pads in the same footprint versus between two pads on different components? Well, one of the values that I've been told from a PCB fabricator that I've worked with for a long time is to just use a blanket value of 5 mils everywhere in the PCB layout. I've had other PCB fabricators tell me that 3 mils is an appropriate limit, and I usually set a value of 4 mils when I'm working in a PCB layout. Now, you'll notice that Peter Sage also brought up routing in between pads underneath the solder mask sliver, and that's really something that you encounter in a BGA, but not something in, like, for example, a QFN or a QFP package. When you have a fine pitch package like a QFP or a QFN, there's really not a lot of room to route a trace in between the pads on that package. And you're gonna have a solder mask sliver value of maybe, for example, 3 mils, depending on the value of your solder mask expansion. Now, a value of 3 mil for a solder mask sliver is basically gonna be the same limit that you'll have on the PCB trace width. So it's not really gonna be practical to route in between pads that leave behind a 3 mil solder mask sliver. In addition, you would need to maintain some required clearance between the trace and the nearby pads, so I don't really think that's an applicable situation in most designs. But in any case, whether you're working in Altium Designer or another CAD tool, make sure to set an appropriate solder mask sliver value that allows you to get components reasonably close together while still ensuring you have a solder mask dam between SMD pads in your design.